morning and welcome to the Villages Chapel. We can't tell you how much we are pleased by seeing each one of you here this morning. And I know there's guests among us, and we are so happy that you have joined us. Please sign our guest book out in the foyer when you're done. And I want to make sure to invite you to coffee, tea, and cookies after the service that was just right across the hallway. We will so enjoy getting to meet you and say hello this morning. This is a very special morning. Our Christmas message this morning will be sung and narrated. From early Christian times, the rose has been a sign of divine love. Jesus Christ has been known as the Rose of Sharon. So our cantata this morning is called the Winter Rose. When you ask others what Christmas means to them, some will say, oh, it's the lights. Oh, it's getting together with family and friends. Special music, sending and receiving greeting cards, all of the wonderful things we get to eat, and Santa, gift exchanging, among other things. Well, we hope this morning, this message you take away is one of love. God loves each of us so much that he sent us an incredible gift, his perfect son, Jesus Christ. Please enjoy this presentation. And we'll start this morning with having Madeline and, thank you, light our Advent candles.
This is the lighting of the third Advent candle. And today we light the third Advent candle, the candle of shepherds. It wasn't just another day at the office for these shepherds on the night of our Lord's birth. The spectacular appearance of an angel and the brightness of the sky terrified the shepherds. They, like many others, were waiting for the Messiah, the Redeemer, to come. Someday, after the heavenly messenger left and the sky returned to normal, the shepherds left their shepherding on the countryside and hurried off and found exactly what the angels had told them, a newborn king in a stable. A reading from Luke 8:15 and 16. But the seed on good soil stands for those with a noble and good heart who hear the word, retain it, and by persevering, produce a crop. No one lights a lamp and hides it in a clay jar or puts it under a bed, but instead they put it on a stand so that those who come in can see the light. Now the congregation will join us in the prayer. Lord, fill our journey to Christmas with the same excitement the shepherds experienced when they heard the good news. Along the way, may we learn to look for you in our everyday experience. We worship you, Emmanuel, God with us.
There is not one person in here that does not have specific needs. We believe that God is capable of meeting all of our needs. And that's why we pray. And I'm going to invite you to participate in this prayer. As he taught his disciples to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, And forgive us of our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And deliver us. Father God, you have heard these prayers from each person. We pray, Lord, that as a faithful God you are, we ask that you would minister miraculously in this assembly. There are those who are having pains in their body, discomfort in their inabilities. Father, you are the God that supplies all of our needs according to your riches in Christ Jesus. Thank you. Amen. We're going to ask you to stand and prepare for the doxology. Many of you may not know what that is, but you'll know what that is after you stand and we repeat it. We ask that you would bless these gifts from your people. May they be used for the propagation of the gospel of Jesus Christ, meeting the needs of those who are less fortunate. Thank you, and have your way in us and with us. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen. You may be seated.
Shelter from the cold night air, some place where she could lay her head, where she could give her babe a quiet bed. Was there no room, no corner there in all the town, a spot someone could spare? Was there no soul come to their aid? A stable bare was where the family stayed. Do you have room for the Savior? And do you seek him anew? Have you a place for the one who and died for you? Are you as humble as a shepherd boy, or as wise as men of old? Would you have come that night?
Would you have sought the light?
Do you have
a star arose, a wondrous light, a sign from God this was the holy night. And yet so few would go to see the babe who came to rescue you and me. This child divine is now a king, the gift of life to all the world. And all mankind he saves from doom. But on that night for him there was no room.
Do you have room for the Savior? And do you seek him anew? have you a place for the one who lived and died for you? Are you as humble as a shepherd boy, or as wise as men of old?
Would you have come that night?
Would you have sought the light?
Do you have room? Will you come tonight?
Will you seek the light?
Do you?
Lies frozen beneath the chilling breath of winter, a spotless rose blooms. Against the harsh surroundings, its beauty unfolds, one petal at a time. The winter rose is born so that the garden might be restored.
To blue.
God of creation, you took from the dust of the earth and you created man and woman in your image and in your likeness to have your created beings a relationship with you. And Father, you placed us in a garden that was perfect because we were holy people. And before us was a tree of the knowledge of good and evil and the knowledge of eternal life. And we chose to die. God, help us. Help us to know that you still love us. Amen.
Of Israel says, the rain and the snow come down from heaven. They water and cause it to bud and flourish. In the cold of winter, you will be like a well-watered garden. Your Redeemer, the Rose of Sharon, will come to Zion. Blessed are all who wait for him.
Valley will be lifted high and every mountain made low. Spring will drive winter away and the garden will rejoice like the rose. It will burst into bloom and the glory of the Lord, the splendor of God, will be revealed.
More than lowly.
God, surely this is not the world that you created us to dwell in. There is sickness, there is death, there is disease, there is war among neighbors and friends and family and nations. Lord, is there any hope? Can you come soon? Come soon.
In the bleak midwinter, frosty wind made moan. Earth stood hard as iron and water like stone. Long, long ago. Fragile infant entrusted to Mary and Joseph is the promised one. With wonder, the couple ponders their sacred charge.
Jesus, Holy One,
close your dreary eyes,
little Jesus, precious Son.
Dream of stars and angel songs.
I will stay here by your side. Sleep to peace tonight.
Sleep in peace tonight.
Sleep in peace tonight. Holy Jesus, gift divine. You are safe, my child.
I will kiss away your tears.
Sleep in peace tonight. God prepared a vessel pure to hold his precious flower.
Riches of heaven is born into the household of a poor carpenter. Though he possesses the universe, no one grants him shelter, and he is laid in a manger.
Laid to sleep in a feeding trough. And although he was long awaited, his birth would go unnoticed were it not for a chorus of angels rousing shepherds from their slumber. Terrified at first, the shepherds are awestruck by the sight and sound of these heavenly beings.
Against a backdrop of dazzling light, their unearthly singing is a call to joy, their wings stirring up an infectious rhythm. Captivated by the song, the shepherds are led in a jubilant rush toward the stable.
Unexpectedly, these tenders of sheep dance into the very presence of God's own Lamb.
Many have gone to not see this great day. Many have gone before us with the hope of a brighter day, with the hope of peace at last. This is the day that the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad in it. Thank you for answering our prayer and attending to our need.
Wise men follow the light, bearing gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. But the child they seek is more precious and more fragrant than these. He is the winter rose, God's gift to the world.
To blossom, its splendor revealed to all who embrace it. Spotless and perfect, its beauty is beyond compare. But all too soon, its season passes, and the rose prepares to die. The rose, adorned with thorns, stands in full bloom. But one by one, the petals fall, blood red upon the ground. As they are crushed beneath the feet of the crowd, the fragrance of redemption is released.
Mm-hmm.
God, my mind has been regulated, and my heart has been renewed, and my spirit is open to your will. Lord, come and dwell in these temples of clay, giving us the assurance that yes, you did create us for eternity in your eternal presence. We thank you.
Lord, how I Lo, the winter is past. The rains are over and gone. Once more, the winter rose blooms in the fertile soil of our souls. The Spirit is poured out upon us from on high, its fragrance filling our hearts. The garden has been restored. Be joyful. The season for singing has come.
Now it's your turn. Please join us. It's our turn to sing Lo How a Rose. Would you please stand as you are able? Thank you so much. Everybody, would you have a seat, please? I would like very much to recognize the soloists and the people who made all of this possible in a very, very large way. Would you please give some applause to our wonderful accompanist, Stockton Officer? To our readers and singers over here, her daughters, Kaylin and Eliana. To our soloists, some of you can't see exactly where they are, but Catherine Nymoen and also Jerry Hill. To Diana Halleck, who helped organize all of this and was one of the readers, and to Nick Yannacone, one of our readers as well. That would be great. And of course, to our fantastic Pastor Bill. Thank you so much.
And from all of us in the choir and all of us everywhere, we are so in love with our new music director, Mark Fish.
Shall we have a benediction prayer?
I just want you to know how blessed I am to be in your presence. Many of you know the story. I could have died 4 years ago, but I'm here because somebody gave their heart so that I could live. And I give my heart to you so that you can live. My heart is a heart for God. God loves you incredibly. It blows my mind how much God loves me, when sometimes I don't even love me. But I want you to leave here this morning knowing that God will forever, ever love you. And he hopes for a relationship with you so that there will be no question in your mind, no doubt in your heart when you close your eyes for the last time. And that when you awaken, when you're awake and open your eyes, you see your God face to face. May the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest upon you. May God's presence ever go before you. And may your heart be filled with joy overflowing. And may the peace of God, which surpasses human understanding, keep you safe until he calls us home. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
God bless you and thank you.
God bless you. Let us sing Joy to the World before we go. It's on your sheets there. You may sit. Do you want to stand? Okay, let's stand. Why not?